What's going on, guys? Welcome to another DaVinci Resolve tutorial, and today we're going to be replacing the skies inside DaVinci Resolve. So we're going to be turning this into that. Okay, so let's get started. This tutorial is going to be straightforward. It's not going to be so much about color grading, but rather the technique to use to replace the sky. What I personally think about it, I'm not really big fan of doing any kind of really CGI work or sky replacement within the color grading software. There is a special software for it. But in case, let's say, you have something relatively basic and straightforward, this technique is definitely going to help you and work pretty well. In the, let's say there's your timeline. In this timeline, you have to right click and add another track. Okay, so we're going to call this footage, and we're going to call video 1 sky. Okay, so I'm going to put the footage on the V2, and I'm going to drag the sky at the bottom to V1. Okay, and sky is obviously a still picture. So let's say we're doing a color grading, and I'm going to do red lock film. And just for this tutorial, I'm going to do right click, and I'm just going to use one of the Koji presets. Let's see, this is a red camera, so I'm just going to do something like this. Okay, and probably I'm going to do slightly light color grading. Just something a little bit to kind of give it a nice little look. And I'm probably going to make everything a little bit warmer, just like that. Okay, and like I was saying before, this is not about color grading. Anyways, so here's going to be our sky replacement node. Sky replacement. I'm going to go to the eyedropper over here to the qualifier, and I'm only going to be working in the luminance. I'm going to select the highlight, and I'm going to highlight only the darkest part, okay? And I'm probably gonna soften it a little bit, that way we don't have any hard edges. Hard edges is pretty much the key. We have a little bit light over here, but you know, for the sake of tutorial, we're not gonna be worrying about this too much. I'm also gonna add the mask right now to kinda make a soft feathered selection, just like that. And what I'm going to do next, I'm going to right click and I'm going to add alpha output. And I'm going to drag this to the alpha channel, just like that. Okay, so this kind of looks freaky a little bit, but if we're going to go into key and we're going to click key output and we're going to invert it, then we have a very nice sky replacement. Now, as I was saying, this technique is not perfect because you have a lot of edges, and I personally am not a big fan of using this kind of technique. You sort of can play around, I guess, with the feathering and minimize the impact, but again, probably it's going to be better if you're going to be working in the dedicated software to replace the sky, such as After Effects, Nuke, or whatever else you're using. And over here, if we're gonna go to the actual sky node, we probably can just adjust the position just like that. And to make the whole thing even sweeter, I'm gonna do another node, and in this node I'm just gonna blend pretty much everything together. I'm gonna create a power window somewhere over here, just like that, and I'm gonna add a little bit of the color. Okay, and maybe a little mids, just like this, and probably we can stretch it even further. Okay, we turn this shot into this. Looks really cool. Looks actually surprisingly very good considering. But in case if you have something more complicated, I definitely recommend in the future using more advanced software such as After Effects, Nuke, or any other software that you're using. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Make sure to subscribe. Leave the comments below what you think, and I'll see you soon.